What I want to do in this video is think about the relationship between variables and then think about what the graph of that relationship should look like. So let's say in these two axes, let's say on the horizontal axis over here, I plot the price of a product. And let's say in this vertical axis right over here, I plot the demand for a product. And I'm only plotting the first quadrant here because I'm assuming that price can only be positive, and I'm assuming that the demand can only be positive, that people aren't going to pay someone to take the product away from them. So let's think about what would happen for the price and demand, or for most normal products. So if the price is low, you would expect that a lot of people are willing to buy that thing. They're like, oh, it's a good price. I would like to buy it. So if the price is low, then the demand would be high. So maybe it would be someplace over here, all the way that you would have really high demand if the price was zero. So if the price was low, the demand would be high. Now what happens is the price, so right here the price is low, demand is high. If price were to go up a little bit, maybe demand goes down a little bit. Right? Price went up a little bit, demand went down a little bit. If price went up a little bit more, maybe demand goes down a little bit more. And so if price went up a bunch, then demand would go down a bunch. And so the line that represents how demand relates to price might look something like this. Might look something like this. And I'm just going to assume for this video that it's a line. It might not be a line. It might be a curve. It might look something like that. Or it might look something like that. But in general, if someone were to ask you, if you saw this magenta curve there, that as price increases, what happens to demand? You just say, well, look, price increases. As price increases, what happens to demand? Well, demand is decreasing. Now let's think about a different scenario. Let's imagine that we're talking about the demand for real estate, for actual property. And let's say that on this axis, we plot the population in the area. And then this is right over here, this is demand for land. So when the population is very low, you could imagine, if the population is zero, there's no one there who would even want to buy land. So if the population is very low, the demand is going to be very low. And as population increases, demand should increase. If the population grows a little bit, more people are going to want to buy land. And if the population goes up a bunch, then a lot of people are going to want to buy land. So you would see a line that looks something like this. And once again, I drew it as a line. It doesn't have to be a line. It could be a curve of some kind. It could be a curve that looks like that, or a curve that maybe looks like that. We don't know. But the general idea is that if someone were to show you a graph that looked like this and said, how does, as population increases, what happens to demand? Well, you'd say, look, this is population increasing. What happens to demand? Demand is going up. Here, as price increased, demand went down. Here, as population is increasing, demand went up. And you could just make that more general with variables. We're talking about specific cases here. But if I were to plot something like this, if you were to see a graph that looked like that, and this is the variable x, and this is the variable y, and someone were to ask you, what happens to y as x increases? Well, you take any x, that's the y that we're at for that x, and as you increase x, as you move in the positive horizontal direction, as you increase x, what's happening to y? Y is going up. So for this example, as x increases, y is increasing. If we had a graph that looked like this, let's call that the a-axis and this is the b-axis, and maybe our graph went like this. And you say, what happens as a increases? So if you pick an a right over here, we're at that a and that b right over there. As a increases, what's happening to b? Well, as a increases, our point of the line is now going down. Our b is lower. As a increases here, b is decreasing. So just want to give you a general idea. When x and y increase together, the line goes from the bottom left to the top right. We would call this an upward sloping line. We would say this has a positive slope. When x increases and y increases, every time x increases, y also increases, is upwards sloping, positive slope. When our independent variable increases and our dependent variable decreases, When the independent variable is increasing, then you say it has a downward slope or negative slope, and we go from the top left to the bottom right.